Hello and assalamu alaikum. This is lecture number 7 and in this lecture I will discuss about the geothermal energy. Geothermal energy is the heat energy that is derived from the earth's crust or subsurface of the earth. Water and steam carry the geothermal energy to the earth's surface. Depending upon the characteristics, geothermal energy can be variably used in heating purposes and cooling purposes, or it can also be harnessed to generate electricity. It is known as the renewable energy source, and heat is continuously produced due to slow decay of radioactive particles in the earth's core. The earth's inner core, outer core, mantle and crust. These are the four major parts of the earth's crust. The earth's inner core is the innermost geological layer of the earth, and it is primarily known that it is a type of a solid ball, and it is believed to have a radius of 1220 kilometers, that is about 760 miles, and it composes about 20% of Earth's radius or 70% of Moon's radius. The next one is the Earth's outer core, that is composed of molten rock or magma. The Earth's outer core is a fluid layer and is about 2400 kilometer or about 1500 miles thick, and is composed mainly of iron, nickel and other metals that lies above Earth's solid inner core. So this is the outer core. Now the third one is mantle. The mantle is mostly solid. It is a mixture of magma and other solid rocks. The mantle lies between the Earth's dense superheated core and its thinner outer layer, which is known as the Earth's crust. The mantle is about 2900 kilometers or 1802 miles in thickness, and it is considered that it makes up to 84% of the total volume of our earth. The uppermost layer is the crust, that is mostly composed of rocks and sand. In geology, the crust is the outermost layer of the planet. The crust of the earth is composed of great variety of igneous metamorphic and sedimentary rocks. The crust is underlain by mantle. The upper part of the mantle is composed mostly of rocks. These rocks are denser than the rocks which are found in our environment or uppermost overlying layer, which is known as the crust. The earth's crust is broken into pieces, and those pieces are known as tectonic plates. By definition, the tectonic plates are the pieces of earth's crust and uppermost mantle, and together they are known as lithosphere. Magma comes close to the earth's surface near the edges of the plates, where many volcanic reactions occur and the volcanoes erupt. Lava erupting is partially magma. Rocks and water absorb heat from magma that is deep underground, and that heat is the main source of geothermal energy. So next we will discuss about the location of geothermal energy. Geothermal energy resources are found deep underground and largely undetectable from the Earth's surface. Found on the Earth's surface, they are in the form of volcanoes and fumaroles. Volcanoes are the in the forms of huge rocks and mountains which erupt lava, whereas fumaroles are the openings in the Earth's surface that might be in the form of cracks that emit steam and volcanic gases, which include sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide. They can also occur as holes or fissures near active volcanoes or in the areas where magma has risen into the Earth's crust without erupting. Most active geothermal resources usually found along major tectonic plate boundaries where most volcanoes are located. The most reliable method of locating geothermal reservoirs is via drilling a hole or a well and testing the temperature over there. So this is the basic example of the use of geothermal energy. The first one is the dry steam power plant. The dry steam power plants, and here the steam travels directly to a turbine which drives a generator and we can produce electricity. The second one is the flash steam power plant. The flash steam power plants take high pressure hot water from the deep inside of the Earth's crust and convert it into the steam to drive generators. When the steam cools, it condenses to water and it is injected back in through injection well. Most of the geothermal power plants are using this technology known as dry steam power plant technology. The third one is binary cycle power plant. The heat from the geothermal fluids causes the secondary storage of liquid or water to flash or vaporize, which is subsequently used to turn this turbine, and the turbine produces electricity via generator. Now we will discuss about the applications of geothermal energy. Direct use of district heating system is one of the main services available from geothermal energy. The main service available from the district heating system are the space heating, hot water distribution, and also it can be used for cooling purposes. These types of systems use hot water from springs or reservoirs which are located near the spaces where geothermal energy is available in a radius of 1 mile or 2 miles. The other application is the industrial usage of thermal energy, which include food dehydration, gold mining, and pasteurizing milk. The geothermal electricity generator requires water or steam at high temperatures, and its temperature can range from 300 degrees to 700 degrees Fahrenheit. Generally, the geothermal energy electricity generation power plants are filled where the geothermal reservoirs are located or within a radius of 1 or 2 miles of its earth surface. The fourth one is the geothermal heat pumps that use constant temperatures near the earth surface to heat or cool the buildings. The main concept is to transfer heat from ground into buildings during winters and reverse the process in summers. This is the closed loop system of a house that is using the geothermal energy. These are the water pipes, and water is circulated inside the house. We use water pumps to transfer heat from underground reservoirs into the building in winter, from which the building can heat up, and in winters the same amount of energy is converted backward to heat the house. The basic principle is that the temperature beneath the ground, if you go 10 feet below the ground level, the temperatures are warmer in winter and cooler in summers.